Let's check out statistics for Nomergon. These are the average parses. We never look at these. We're pretty much always going to start with 95% and then go to max. And the 95 percentile over the range of 1 day, it's Fire Mage on top. Enhance Shaman, number two, in the 95th percentile, followed by Warlocks and Melee Hunters. This is your current breakdown with the buff. Frost Mage is just not even on the same planet as anyone else. They're just PvPs. This is a 100% PvP spec. DPS Paladins have gone down. It's not looking hot for DPS. Now let's look at what the max percentile is. I personally prefer to look at max because like this is what a class can do with every advantage and every class buff and raid buff that they can possibly get is the max percentile. So if you're looking at what a class can actually do if they're given all the buffs into the raid, the max is the best way to look at it. Fire Mages getting PI are still king with all the fights. But this is padded because of Menagerie. Fire Mages do so much damage on Menagerie that they're kings of the raid. If Menagerie was not in here, it would not be Fire Mages. It would be Warlocks and Warriors. Now, it's nice to see that Enhanced Shamans are coming up. But as you can see, Warriors who do everything in their power to parse really high can still be extremely effective. It's not very likely that the majority of Warriors are able to do that. This is a more realistic breakdown, is like the 99th percentile of how classes are actually doing right now. And overall, Fire Mage is best because of the Menagerie fights, and then Enhancement Shaman are just the DPS single target kings right now, is what it's looking like. Now let's look at the single target fight. Let's look at Crowd Pummeler or Electrocutioner. Single target kings right now, Enhancement Shaman, if you look at max and we take PIs and everything into it, Enhancement Shamans are still beating Warriors in single target damage. We can even look at Crowd Pummeler. Now, this boss has a ton of armor, which is why melees can't compete. But Enhanced Shamans have done leaps and bounds for melee on this boss, and they're actually still pretty close. If we do 99%, you'll see them get even closer. Is because Enhanced Shamans don't really benefit from PI like Warlocks and Mages do in the max percentile. And at 95%, I think they even get even close. But on a pure single target fight without insane amounts of armor, it's 100%. Enhancement Shamans are the kings of like single target right now. Grubbus is a bit skewed because it's a 20-second fight at the max percentile. But in the 95th percentile, when you're just hitting one target, Enhancement Shamans is kings on Grubbus. They probably do pretty well on Viscus, but it's a multi-target, so Warriors and Mages might actually outparse them. Menagerie is a four-target fight, so Elemental Shamans should pass them. Nothing should be close to Fire Mage on this fight, like not even in the same ballpark. And then Thermoplug Enhancement Shaman should be on top as well. We have Elemental Shamans passing them, actually. Okay, at the 99th. In the 99th percentile, Warlocks getting PI are going to be the single target kings. They're going to be able to slightly outperform Enhancement Shamans. In a regular raid with no buffs on a single target boss that is not boosted armor, Enhancement Shaman is king right now. And so you have different specializations for different fights. But overall, the buff that they gave to Enhancement Shamans was insane. It took them from mid-pack all the way to top DPS on some of these fights, which is insane. Especially in the 95th percentile. And it's actually good to see Elemental Shaman starting to really pump now on certain fights. Look at Enhanced Shaman on Electrocutioner, guys. No one's even close. I raid tonight. I'm excited to try all this stuff later. That's what's up, Zod. You're gonna kill it tonight, man. I promise you're gonna kill it. Enhanced, nothing can even come close to Enhanced Shaman, I feel like, right now on single target damage. On a fight that's not just incredibly skewed. Even in the max percentile, they're still outpumping warriors on single target damage. Which is nuts. But the fact that warriors are performing this well on single target fights is scary to me. Because warriors and enhanced shamans will already outscale ranged DPS with the way that World of Warcraft works with world buffs and damage scaling off weapon damage and stats. It's unhealthy for the game at level 40 to have warriors on top. It's very unhealthy because this will be like, this bar will be off the screen at level 60 and everybody else will still be right here. That's what I'm scared of, is them making melee damage this good at level 40. That's just the way it goes, boys. Wow. Okay. I think it was cool that Enhancement Shamans got buffed, but was the buff too much? Maybe. And the problem is, guys, if you buff Frost Mage, then they become like way too strong in PvP. So I'm okay with Frost Mage being dog in the raid, like just not being good. I'm a bit concerned with Warriors being this good. At the 95th percentile, it's not too much of a big deal. But for melees to be performing this well on certain bosses is pretty scary overall. Because they only get better. Rogues? Can we just talk about rogues for a second, guys? I feel like rogues need something. Now, I've been saying this. But can we give rogues a little something? I feel like Rogue is the only class in this expansion that didn't get something. They need something. I don't even play Rogue. But I have no reason to bring a Rogue into my raid, ever. I would like a reason to bring a Rogue. If that makes sense. Give a party buff or a raid-wide buff or tricks or something to rogues, please, Blizzard, so that they can feel included in Season of Discovery. What about Ferals? Ferals got wild strikes. Ferals, you need a Feral in every single group in Alliance. I don't want to hear Ferals talking. You know what I mean? Like, Feral is a utility class that can play every spec. There's no reason Ferals should be on the top damage. They're already... You're there to juice other classes. Now, here's the thing. Enhanced Shaman also can play every class. Or can play every spec. And I don't think that hybrid specs should ever do more damage than a class that only does damage, like Hunter. Hunter is the only true damage class left in the game. You know what I mean? Wild Strikes is better than Wind Fury too. Yeah, there's no reason for Ferals to complain. Ferals are in a good spot. They should be mid-pack. Rogues are the only tank that can grief the raid by being able to use Vanish. That's why I don't bring a Rogue tank. That's just another reason to not bring them. What I'm trying to say, bro, is we need a reason to bring a rogue tank. That's just another reason not to bring one. Can you do a tank summary? I mean, are we really caring about tanks, guys? I mean, you want to see which tank is doing the most damage overall? How do you, I don't even know if you can filter by tanks, bro. I don't know if you can filter by tank damage. I think I have to just do that manually. You just got to go to rankings right here and then just filter it normally and then see which tank is doing the best. All right, Warlock tanks are doing 255. 455. Warrior tanks are doing 377. Shaman tanks, 584. What the hell? Dude, what? That's not even fair, guys. Paladin tanks? 480? Rogue tanks? 334! Sheesh! Get them out of here, boys! Okay. If you guys don't think Shaman is just completely busted, we're out of our minds at 584 DPS. Overall, that's more than my mage. I just looked at warrior tanks. They're doing like 300. They're doing 377. Okay, guys. Wait a second. The shaman tanks are doing the same amount of DPS as the shaman, as the enhancement shamans. These tanks are doing the same amount of damage. Whatever they're doing, whatever these guys are doing, they're literally just enhancement shamans. That you're pretty much just playing DPS. Top parsing shaman tanks are not using alpha. They're dual wielding. Dual wielding tanking to top parse. They're running. Okay, they're just running. They're just running DPS, but they have one rune on that makes them go into the tank category. And they're spamming mana pots. Okay, so they need really short fights. As a prop warrior, I feel very competent. Massive defensive CDs, but I'd much rather have the damage throughput than these cooldowns. This is insane. How in the world? We gotta fix this, guys. I mean, it is kind of cool to be able to crank like this. But Shaman is set up to where, like, you could still tank. Because their taunt is part of their damage rotation, like, they just deal so much threat that they don't even need the help for mitigation. And the bosses don't hit hard enough to where they need a shield. And so, like, the tank trinity, the tank healer DPS trinity at the top end, it slowly fades away. Because the bosses just don't hit hard enough in Classic. Especially on the level up raids. So, these shamans are all kind of doing something, which it's hard to even classify them as a tank because they're just enhancement shamans. I mean, yeah, they're just enhancement shamans. Since everyone got the same armor, it basically became a shit stat. Yeah. I would love to see the bosses hit harder and stuff and like bring mitigation back into the game. But maybe like the patchwork style fights, those are going to come at level 60. So in the level up raids, it's not a big deal. I mean, yeah, shamans are on top now. But let's see how it plays out at level 60, I think. How are the healers doing? How's the HPS numbers? Priest on top still. Couple of mages. Nothing can compete with the priest. Resto druid a little bit. But mages are kind of down bad. Druid on the top with overhealing, of course. Yeah, they just stack hots on everything. I have a druid tank, warrior tank, warlock tank, and I don't know which one to focus on. Look at the overall healing. All bosses. Dude, raids and statistics. Oh, you're talking about here? Oh, you want to see the bars. Healing to tanks. All right. There you go. Tank healing, paladins are king. And let's just do healing in general. Overall healing at the top, let's do 95 for now. So druids are bis for just overall healing to raid. Yo, these are really good healing number like breakdowns. All the healers are pretty close. How about max? I mean, I don't think you should ever look at max on healing. Like 95 is good. Because if you look at max on healing, they're doing weird stuff to get more HPS. Healers are in a good spot. I don't ever think that mage should be top DPS or should be top healing because they can do a lot of their healing through damage. And it's good that mage is not top. Shamans will start to creep up once they get bigger chain heals. Once they're doing more, once we get like fights that do more raid damage at level 60 and we get bigger groups, shamans will start to creep. Because the chain healing throughput, you need more people that are taking damage, like more melee in the group. Like shamans are for the horde side, shamans are the AoE, like they're the throughput healers primarily. You need one shaman in every group at level 60. And priests are actually single target healers on the horde. And pallies are the single target healers on the alliance. And priests are the AoE healers. Like they swap roles just depending on what side you're playing on. I feel like priests, I mean, the healing breakdown looks good. They look like they're in a pretty good spot. If you want better healing in your raids, you'd probably go druid priest. Druid priests are going to be the best overall healing in the raid. And then if you want more damage in heals, then you take like a mage in there. Resto shaman is probably not meta right now, but it doesn't matter. I mean, the raid is super easy. You can get through it with pretty much anything. All right, boys, that's it for the DPS of the week. I feel like I don't really want to say it, guys, but shamans are OP. I don't know if anybody agrees with me, but they might have overtuned shaman just a little bit. Dare I say, boys. What do you think they need to do for DPS rogues to make them relevant? I think you just give them tricks. You give them tricks, and while they have tricks up for like the first 10-15 seconds of a fight, they get a damage buff, and it gives a damage buff to the tank. That would be a pretty cool change, right, guys? Increased 20% increased damage with tricks up. Rose, like 10-15 seconds of tricks duration, and they put it on the tank at the start of the fight, and they get increased 20% increased attack speed or damage, and they also give damage and crit to the tank for 20 seconds or something like that. Or they maybe rogues just get the buff, but all the threat goes to the tank. I think every single person I've asked about rogues says tricks is the best thing that they can add to the game right now. You know what I mean? Like, nobody disagrees with it. Everyone is saying, give rogues tricks. Like, it's like the number one thing people are saying. A shroud rune? I don't think we need shroud for anything in classic. There's no mythic plus. I mean, you could shroud your whole... That would be kind of cool. You shroud your whole raid in a world... you shroud your entire raid into Molten Core and then just pop up out of nowhere. That'd be kind of sick for world PvP. But I don't know if that would, like, if they would ever put that specific ability into Classic. I can't really see it make a big reason. Tricks and Misdirect are great spells. I love Tricks and Misdirect. I think they're both fantastic. Rogues. Oh, Rogue AoE is where I don't know. You guys, you have to be careful about giving every class everything. You have to be careful. If you give every class everything, it makes you have less class identity. I would love... Cloak of Shadows could be cool. One thing rogues don't have right now is, like, rogues should be very high in melee DPS. But they're lacking a little bit of damage right now. And they need something for the raid to make you want to bring them. Like, the only thing that they really bring to a raid that nobody else can do is disarm trap. It's like you just need a couple of those for Blackwing Lair. But other than that, I can't really think of a major reason to bring a rogue. I want AoE threat for warrior. I personally think that the game is more fun in general without target caps and seeing how many mobs you can pull and how fast you can clear stuff. Like, I do like that a lot. But class identity is important too. It's like you always want to keep mage as the AoE king. That is retail. As I say, you got to keep classic. You got to keep the classic. Keep the class identity. Give people some good stuff. But don't overdo it. You know what I mean? You got to be careful about that. You want to keep the class identity. You don't want to overbuff people. And you don't want to give everybody everything.